In 2017, Michael Riccati, the man you see here, was left paralyzed from the waist down after a motorbike accident. 3 years later, he was able to walk again thanks to a revolutionary spinal cord implant. He can now stand for up to 2 hours and walk almost a mile without stopping.
Researchers warn this technology is still in its early stages and significant work remains before the implant is available outside clinical studies. Dr. Andreas Rowald from the Swiss Federal Institute of Technology is part of that team that developed the implant and is with us to tell us more. Good morning.
Good morning.
What was the breakthrough that allowed this technology to happen, and how long did that take?
So there's really two breakthroughs. The first one is a computational framework we developed to optimize and personalize this neurotechnology. And the second one is an electrode implant that we developed specifically for people who suffer from paralysis due to spinal cord injury. Mm-hmm. Combining these two technologies, we had a technology that was completely optimized and personalized for that particular purpose, which took approximately 4 years just to do this one study, but it was building up on decades of research that has been conducted in this field.
It's very exciting to see this, and I'm sure for the community it's got to be amazing. Talk about how far away you are from this becoming something that people can use all day long, or is it that the average person with a spinal cord injury might have access to?
So, I mean, right now we're, of course, in the research setting, and it's still going to be quite a long and challenging way to bring this therapy into clinics across the world. I would say that we're approximately 4 to 6 years away from actually being able to implement this in clinics. However, even then, of course, the therapy is probably going to be restricted to a few cases before we're able to actually scale this up to be a common treatment for people with spinal cord injury.
But it's not, I think people might think this is a cure. It is not, you're careful to say this is not a cure.
Yeah, we have to be very careful here because right now we have very little evidence to demonstrate that this is a cure. What we can say at this point is that it's a prosthetic, so we can use this in order to enable walking movement in people with spinal cord injury. Whether there's going to be a therapeutic avenue to this is still to be determined.
And do you see this being something that is affordable, or is this something that's going to cost a lot of money, and which raises its own debate?
Right. I mean, at the moment, of course, this is going to cost a lot of money, but we're working very hard, working together with industrial partners to make this a more affordable treatment. And there's various technological avenues that we're trying to exploit to reduce the costs and reduce the time necessary to create walking in people with spinal cord injury. So hopefully we can make it into a therapy that will be broadly applicable to people with spinal cord injury.
Well, congratulations. It's just so exciting. Nine people have this implant. Can you tell us maybe one of their reactions to being able to walk for the first time in a long time?
I mean, of course, it's an incredibly emotional situation. What you have to realize is that in three of these people, we were able to elicit walking movement as early as on the first day of therapy optimization. So for them, of course, in this one moment, it's an absolute shock.
Yeah.
And they're quite often overwhelmed with joy. Actually, so is the entire team that is present during these sessions. I remember like being in these sessions and essentially everybody had tears in their eyes.
Oh, well, it's amazing. For more information, you can check out the website on your screen. Dr. Rowald, thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you, doctor.
It's a pleasure. Thank you.
So